The DeSantis administration down here in the state of Florida has found themselves in a very uncomfortable position. And they tried to avoid this uncomfortable position earlier this year when the Republican-controlled Florida state legislature voted to end decades of open records laws here in the state of Florida in order to shield Ron DeSantis's travel records, not just from the public, but from the media and apparently possibly even from law enforcement in the state. And that's created some problems. According to a whistleblower with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, they actually tried to release some of Ron DeSantis's travel records following a Freedom of Information Act request from the Washington Post. Now, the whistleblower was with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. There was another woman with her at the time, a lawyer, and they said, listen, we understand there's this new law that says we can't release these records. But look, we got some records here, you know, they're older, like there's no reason we can't release these. The media is asking for them, you know, they're filing these requests. We should honor it because if we don't, by the way, we're going to get sued. So there's no harm in this. Let's just do it. Ron DeSantis' staffers, according to a report from the Washington Post, fired back and said, no, absolutely not. And that's when things started to get bad. Because the whistleblower, who was about to get a promotion, then had her promotion, according to her, blocked by the DeSantis administration. She went to go seek whistleblower protection, and that was denied by the state's government. Then she was fired. So, story kind of tells itself right there, right? But here's the thing. The Republicans in this state are shielding Ron DeSantis's travel records, not because of security concerns, not because, oh, something bad could happen if we release these. It's because the dude has been crisscrossing the country for a year and a half now, running for president, even though his official campaign didn't launch until May, after they passed the law, of course. You know, let's make sure we get that in place before he officially runs. And they don't want us to see who's paying for what. It's as simple as that. Is Ron DeSantis using my tax dollars to run for president of the United States? And that's the answer, by the way, that the media outlets want to know. Not based on just my tax dollars, but the tax dollars of everybody here in Florida. They want to know if this man is abusing the state in order to run for president. And Republicans in Tallahassee down here, our state capital, said, you can't know that. The DeSantis administration is telling law enforcement they can't know that. And if you try to say they should know it, like this whistleblower did, we're going to punish you. We're going to come after you. Now, this woman that was fired, denied the promotion and all of that, she's got a very strong lawsuit on her hands. And I imagine if she hasn't already, she is going to file one. And maybe it'll all come out on the wash. But it could be years before that happens. But I think by the time all this is over, we will know everything. And there's little doubt in my mind that Ron DeSantis is using our money to run for president. And if I'm wrong, prove me wrong by releasing those records.
What are you doing? It's over. The video's over. I'm done complaining about everything and that's it. The end. Leave. Well, okay, if you're going to stick around, maybe you should give us a like, a comment, a share, or just subscribe to stay connected with all of our content. Or maybe you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks. Just follow the link in the description. Now, go. Just go.